And joining us now to talk about the threat of online scams and how you can protect yourself is Jeffrey Robinson, an online security expert, joins us from our London bureau. And Jeffrey, to go from a victim to a scam artist, does that happen from time to time?
Unfortunately, it happens all the time. The Nigerians who start these email scams, once they get their teeth into you, they never let go. They've got scams, and then they've got follow-up scams that are designed to come behind the original scam. They also, by the way, once they have a victim and bilk them 2-3 times, they then sell the victim's email address and information to other scammers. Once you've been hit, you never get away.
I know. I guess not. They feel like they have you, and so they're going to keep trying to bilk you as much as they can. Well, they target anyone in particular? Do they target people in particular?
They certainly target the elderly, senior citizens. They target students. But you know what? They're non-discriminatory. They target everybody. In fact, every man, woman, and youngster watching Good Morning America this morning will be targeted by professional fraudsters multiple times over the next 12 months. And 1 in 9 will lose money as a result of fraud. That's how bad this has gotten.
Yeah, not multiple times over the month. Multiple times a day you'll get some emails from, and not just from Nigeria, but all these scams. So what are the ones that we should really be looking out for right now, Jeffrey? What's out there?
Well, lottery fraud is so big. I mean, you get an email saying that you've won a lottery. Trust me, if you didn't buy a ticket, you didn't win the lottery. It's that simple. Another one that I actually followed was a work-at-home fraud. This is the lottery. This is the email that arrives and says, we're an English a fabrics company, and we are looking for someone in the States to represent our interests and collect money for us. And what will happen is our client, to pay us, will pay you with a cashier's check. You deposit it into your bank account, wait till the money clears, and then wire the money out. Now, on the surface, it sounds about right. But if you look very carefully at it, what you find is, do a Google. The address in England doesn't exist. The name of the managing director is a name that's been used in other frauds. He's got a Gmail or a Hotmail address, not a company address. He's using a cell phone, not a switchboard. And the checks are, of course, counterfeit. So once you deposit it into your account, 3 days later, you see that the check has cleared, or at least you think it's cleared, and in fact, it hasn't. The bank has simply advanced you the money 4 days or 5 days after you've wired out 90%, because your share is supposed to be 10%.
Oh, my goodness.
The bank informs you that the check has bounced, and you owe them the $3,000 or $4,000.
I mean, all the work, so sophisticated. And I got to tell you, Jeffrey, there was it was last year. I got in the car, and it was early. I was kind of tired. There was an email that came to me from a friend, and saying that she was overseas, she lost her wallet, and there was just enough information to sound right, and to say that she, could you help her out, that could you send something? And I was tired. I was like, you know, this doesn't quite sound right, but there's enough information here. And I did a Google search and found the exact same letter that was online like that. So what can you do to, I know you say if it sounds too good to be true, it probably isn't, but there's some really sophisticated people out there trying to get some money out of us.
There are very sophisticated people. That particular scam works off a virus that goes into your email account and spreads emails throughout from your address book to all your friends. What you do is read the letter very carefully. If somebody wants to use your bank account, they're a crook. Flat and simple, categoric, they're a crook. There is no reason for anybody or any company to need your bank account at all. Never disclose your password, never disclose your identity. Keep your bank account private. Also, read the emails. If it's addressed, dear trusted friend, that's not you. That's sent to thousands of people. Look at the English involved. A lot of these emails, the English is very stilted, and yet they claim to be British or American. No, no, no. If you get an email from somebody offering to share money with you and you don't know them, it's a scam. Throw it away. Strangers don't share money with other strangers.
They don't. But bottom line, if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is.